because you're not an idiot. Let's just humor him. Yates likes his little games. Don't be long.
You got my message.
You'd never get caught on camera. Not unless you wanted to be seen. So what's the play?
You're not the only one who's been busy, 47. I'm this close to becoming the next Constant. I'll be able to dismantle Providence from the inside. Only one man stands in my way. Don Yates. That weasel was the partner's legal counsel for years. He's the top candidate. But remove him from the playing field.
It won't work. If Edward suspects...
I will convince him you acted alone. Retaliation for Gray. Trust me, I know what I'm doing.
The Herald, Tamara Vidal. She has eyes everywhere, and they're all fixed on you. The plan won't work unless we take her out.
She never leaves my side for long. Whatever your plan is, I'll help you if I can.
You're sure about this?
As sure as I'll ever be. Here, I got you an invitation, just like old times. Come find me when it's done. Good luck, 47.
Ready, Pam? 3, 2, 1, and...
For more than 2 decades, New York-based law firm...
Valentina must be over the moon about Don's sitting down. She's been living alone here for, what, 6 years? Ever since the scandal that ruined her
career. Bienvenidos to Viñeda Yates, señor. May I see your invitation, please? Gracias, señor. Enjoy the party.
Tamara Vidal.
I'm
here for the tour.
Ah, yes. Miss Vidal. My apologies. I didn't recognize you. Let me sign you in.
Luther? Burnwood's flying solo. I want all I
got. Corvo, got a message from the boss.
And Luther?
Duty calls.
Let me guess, the Burnwood woman.
That's right. Gates has arranged for the chief winemaker to take Burnwood and Tamara Vidal.
Yates came down and told the poor sod in charge of the tanks a new one.
You'd think there was some kind of fail-safe mechanism or early warning system in place.
Yeah, you would, but you'd be wrong. If the pumps malfunction or a tank sounds like
brain, puto baboso.
Just go see what it was.
Okay, I'll do it.
Who's the boss?
Ah!
Sir, I present to you the 1945 Grand Paladin.
Huh. Somehow I thought it'd be bigger. Come on, Flowers. Guests are waiting. Go on, get yourself patted down. We're still on alert from all those big shot CEOs getting offed.
I need to search you if you want to pass. That's good. Keep those arms there. Don't move. If I find something, I'm gonna crucify you. Okay. You are good to go.
So here's the deal, Flowers. The boss is having a powwow with some employees, and discretion is the name of the game. I'm sure you figured that out already, you being a scholar and all. Don't discuss, disclose, or hell, even contemplate what goes down. Just set your mind to wool-gathering mode. You think you can do that for me, Flowers?
Worry not, Mr. Cortazar. I'm the very soul of discretion.
Good man. They're already at it. Go on, place the wine on the table. I'll pour it.
Decant.
Pardon me, Your Majesty.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Flowers, our resident sommelier. I believe he has brought us something quite special. Perhaps you will educate us, Mr. Flowers.
This is the 1945 Grand Paladin, one of only five bottles in existence. The vintage is legendary. The proverbial unicorn wine. The year was hot. The wine's super concentrated, and thanks to hail and frost, the production was small. Only 300 bottles were ever produced. And when the vineyard was bombed during the closing days of World War II, only a single crate survived. It is said to have amazingly complex aromas with long, savory layers of fruit and spice flavors and a silky texture. Enjoy.
Wonderful. Thank you, Mr. Flowers. Feel free to stick around in case our guests have questions. This wine was gifted to me by the Arch Society in acknowledgement of my firm's legal services. It stands as a powerful reminder that Providence draws its strength not from force, but from partnership. We are but a few, and yet together, we are unstoppable, because we stand united. My friends, loyalty is everything, which is why we cannot allow traitors into our ranks.
Ah, yes. Here it comes.
This woman has waged bloody war on us. More than a dozen heralds and operatives dead. Your colleagues and clients, my friend Ken Morgan, not to mention the partners themselves, our founders, our benefactors. Make no mistake, this woman's hands are soaked in blood, our blood. And Arthur Edwards, the new supreme head of Providence, is handing her the keys to the kingdom. Now, does that seem right to you, my friends? Does that sound like loyalty?
Oh, absolutely. I agree. Absolutely.
Perhaps Edwards simply recognizes talent when he sees it. Perhaps this is why I am also in the running to become constant and following this childish outburst. I dare say I am in the lead, Dawn.
You're lying, of course, which only proves my point. You cannot be trusted, Miss Burnwood. This woman will be our downfall. That is, unless we take matters into our own hands. You are heralds, sworn to protect Providence against all threats, including inside ones. I have devised a plan. Together we can make it work, but you have to decide now, my friends. Are you with me?
Yes.
Yes.
I'm in.
I agree. Yes.
Yes.
Listen to yourselves. Don Yate is not even appointed Constant yet. And already he conspires to betray his master. I don't pretend to understand Edward's every move, but I do know that this man is an opportunist and unworthy of office.
Then you are a traitor to the heralds. The room is against you, Tamara. Stand down now or share her fate.
Edwards will hear about this.
I think not. I am sorry, but you brought this on yourself. Mr. Cortazar? Escort Miss Burnwood to my office. I'll join you shortly.
Right. Move it. Let's go.
I'm warning you, Yates. This will not go your way.
We need to get our story straight. Diana Burnwood died today by the hand of her rogue agent 47. Tamara Vidal, right, who saw through the assassin's disguise, was, alas, killed as well. This what
Jeez.
Come in. I've heard something weird. I'm gonna go check it out.
Awesome.
Took you long enough. Quick, clear the floor and get yourself a guard outfit. Gates won't be long. Good. I was beginning to worry.
Were you?
No. Listen up, 47. Yates will be here shortly. He'll have his thug Cortazar do his dirty work, but he won't pass up on the chance for a good gloat and a monologue.
So, private space? Kill room decor?
Exactly. We won't get another shot at this. Now sit down and blend in. When I provide a distraction, you just be ready to move.
Corvo, pick up your damn phone. Plan B is a go. I repeat, Plan B is a go. Start prepping a crime scene. Like we discussed, remote, staged accident. Oh. Corvo, make it for two. Just improvise.
Confident even in defeat. I suppose you're not used to danger, old.
What the hell, man?
Why would Edwards trust you?
Please.
It will keep me awake at night till I'm 65. I get up four times to piss as it is.
Oh, it's simple, really. Edwards is proud. He considers himself the cleverest man alive, and yet we tricked him on Isle of Scale, and it's eating him up. He needs to win. Full, unequivocal victory. My recruitment was just the feather in his cap. By the way, you were right about one thing.
Yeah, I'm all ears.
Turns out this woman will isolation, Dawn.
What are you doing, you asshole? Don't just stand there! Shoot her!
And I will make it my mission to tear down Providence brick by brick. Finish it.
Such a good boy.
Thank you.
Well done, 47. Better get rid of the body. Won't be long before they come looking. When you're done, meet me on the dance floor. Oh, and dress appropriately.
It's done. Now what?
Now, we strike at the heart.
Edwards. You know how to find him, don't you?
Why, Edwards finds you, 47. He is untraceable, and he never lets you forget it. He is cocky. And that will be his downfall.
What's the plan?
Too many eyes. Meet me at the Olive Grove at sunset. One last tango, 47.